Hang all the mistletoe, I'm gonna get to know you better. This Christmas.
Hey YouTube, happy Tuesday. It's day two of my braid out. I wanted to come and show you what it looks like after I take my bunnet off. Right now, I can honestly tell you all, I am not feeling day one braid out. I felt like my hair looked like crochet weave because that's what I kept getting. And I guess I was missing the fullness of my hair after not being having a retie for 8 weeks. And this whole braid out thing is totally different for me. So hopefully, I'm going to like day two of this hair. So let's see what it looks like. All right, here we are. This is the first time I've taken my hair down this morning, so I did not put my rings on yet because I never do until I have to fluff out this hair. It's definitely different than what I'm used to. I just want my volume. Length back. I'm not going to spray any rose water on it because, like I said, I want to see how long this braid out is going to last. So, I guess I can honestly say I'm feeling it a little bit more today, maybe because it's falling. So, okay. Might be able to do this today. I don't know what's up with this little piece of hair right there. Okay, y'all, here we go. I guess I need to eat my words. Well, no, I'm not going to eat my words from day one because I wasn't feeling day one. So, hopefully, day two hair looks more like my hair. And I don't get comments like, where did I get my hair from? Because I got it from my mama and God. That's where I got it from. So, okay. What y'all think? You know, I gotta let y'all see the full view. So, okay, here we are, day two, braid out hair, and we'll see what day three looks like tomorrow. So, see y'all. This is day three of my braid out. Again, have not taken my bunnet off. Just took my shower, did a little something to my face. And now we're about to flip the hair out. So let's see what day three looks like. Okay. Day two for me was still kind of okay. I don't want to move today. It's just like, there. Come on. I'm really just trying not to put any type of water, rose water on it, because I'm just trying to see how long these crinkles are going to last, because I do not plan on braiding it up. I just want to see what it's going to do. As a natural, I was told that the type of hair I had, which is really big, coily hair, was really good at holding a style. Once my hair got a style, it held it. So, that still should be the same with locks, which of course I see that it might be. When I say might be, it looks like it is, because these bad boys ain't going nowhere. They ain't trying to drop. I think they're still the same length as the day before. So, yeah, I think this is as good as it's going to get right now. So, and I hadn't worked out this week because I didn't want to really sweat out my crinkles, but I might go and do some cardio tonight at Orange Theory and see what happens. I don't know. Because it just does not feel right, me not working out. So, yeah. All right. Here is day three hair of the braid out. Y'all full term. So yeah, so let me know what you think. Is we liking this braid out on me? It's really lasting, so without me braiding it back up. So yeah, so there we are, and I'm gonna get on with my day, and I'll see y'all tomorrow on day 4. Good morning. Today is day 4 of the braid out, and here we go. Today my plan is to pretty much try to make sure I get my fingers through every piece of hair to make sure nothing marries together, because from the looks of it, this braid out ain't going nowhere no time soon. So I started to do it last night, and I was like, no, I'm gonna wait, because I don't want it to look too extremely different in case it did with me putting my fingers through it. Also, no, I did not go and work out last night. So in case you was wondering what that footage was, there was no footage. But yeah, so here we are, day 4 of the braid out. I'm gonna make sure to make sure the hair in the back is down, because I know when I go back and look at footage, I got this piece of hair that's like a bush in the back. So so here's day 4. It's a little bit looser than the other days, but I can see how this can last for, what is this, for a week. Like I said, this is day 4, and then yesterday it was raining here also. Of course, I don't use umbrellas anymore. Well, I hadn't used umbrellas for a very long time, unless it's just a really hard pour down. So, okay. I think I pretty much got it. Make sure my fingers is through everything. Okay, and make sure I lay it down in the book. So yeah, bumping my vanity. But yeah, so here's day 4 hair, and I have to say, I'm liking day 4 hair better, because it is loosening up. It's not as tight as it was, and maybe I'm getting used to this look. So yeah, so here we are, day 4 hair. And we'll see what day 5 hair looks like tomorrow. So here we are. Look for today. And I'll see you all tomorrow morning for day 5 hair. Here we are, day 5 of the braid out. I gotta do this quick because I gotta get to work, because I got a lot going on last day before Christmas, but I wanted to come in to show you all what the hair is looking like today. So here we go. Here we go. Got some serious bedhead going on here tonight. I mean, this morning. You know what I'm talking about. You can tell I'm still asleep. Just trying to get today over with so I can begin my Christmas holiday. All right, so yeah, y'all see we're a little bit more looser, which I like. But like I said yesterday, I think I'm just liking the look now. So it's just getting a little itchy here too. A little scratch. It's so funny when you get your hair retightened after so long. It feels like your scalp starts to kind of itch a little bit more. Because my fat really don't itch, so it just kind of like a different feel. I guess just from the tenderness of the retie. But yeah, here we go. Day 5 of the braid out. So yeah, this definitely lasts a whole week if you don't braid it up. This is definitely a whole week style. So here we go. and I have not spread any rose water on it. The only water that has gotten on it has been like the little sprinkles of rain that I have gotten caught in at least 2 times this week. But that's it. So here we are. And so we're done. Today is day 6 of the braid out. And here we are. Finagre going run some errands to get some last minute Christmas shopping done. So come to you to show you all day 6 of this braid out before I leave. Alright, here we go. I figured that would help eliminate on all the tugging and pulling I've been doing. So we just shake it out. So looks like that helped a little bit. So crinkles are still in full effect. Especially on this side. This side, these crinkles are like holding on for dear life. Like they ain't going nowhere. These are still here too, but they're more looser. So, look at there. I think this is the fastest fluff out all week. What do y'all think? It ain't gonna matter because the wind's gonna take it and do what it wants to do anyway. Here we are. The full view of our crinkle right now. Man, so that is it for today. We are day 7. The final day of what I'm going to document of the braid out. But of course, I will let you all know the exact day the braid out officially ends, whenever that is. But I'm going to go ahead and end this video here, showing you all what day 7 braid out hair looks like. So here we go. Still looks the same like it typically does. And, when we take the bunnet off, we have that bunnet hair. We're gonna help speed up the process a little bit like we did yesterday. And that got me a little dizzy. But I really feel like this braid out is gonna last until I actually put some water on it, or maybe some rose water. Because it's holding tight, it's not going anywhere at all. So yeah, guys, so we can see here, at least with my hair, I have the type of hair where I can hold a braid out without rebraiding it back up, and it just stays and does its own thing. So I think from this point forward, I am going to start mixing it with some rose water and start to see what happens. But here we are, last day. This Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me.